Today, I'm going to start out by building an application on the Appian platform around employee onboarding automation. Let's get started. I'm going to start here in my Appian Design environment, which is my single place for logging in as a developer, as part of a team of developers, to build applications on the Appian platform. Immediately, I can see I have some in-product learning, I have access to documentation and support, and I can start building out a new application right away. Let's give our application a name. We'll also add a prefix. I can add a prefix that is not in use yet, and give this application a description. Appian's automatically going to generate the default groups and folders to secure all of my different objects. By default, it's going to give me an administrator group and a user group, and I can add additional groups here if I want to, or change the permissions. Initially, setting administrator permissions will give a group the ability to do anything around that application, make changes to any objects. Editor will allow them to be able to edit the contents of that application. Viewer will be allow them to view the different objects in that application. And deny is our zero trust. That user group should not be able to see anything in this application. That security is going to help get you off on the right foot in terms of how the application is structured and how it works. All right, what do we want to build first? Let's start with a record type. Of course, we could also start here by building out our new process model, which would be the workflow of our application, or building a new site or portal, which is how end users interact with the data here. Starting off with a new record type, this is going to give us access to define the data that we want to underlie the application. So we'll start off with the most important record, which is going to be that employee. Appian's automatically going to pick up the plural of our different record types. So we added employee, it's going to generate the word employees. And we'll add, you know, a little description here and go ahead and create this. Now, Appian records, this is our concept of what a data entity is. So this is going to be our business noun. If we have an employee, it's not just going to be how we define the employee, but it's also going to be where does that data around the employee live? What relationships are there between an employee and other entities in the system? How do users interact with an employee? Do they take actions? Are there business rules securing that data? Are there interfaces that they might want to see that's going to slice and dice the employee data for them? Also, we should be able to monitor the performance of this data across our application. All of that is going to take place from right within here, right within the Appian Record Designer. So let's get started by telling it about the data. We're going to be able to start with a new from scratch data model, which is going to allow us to select Appian as the source or another data source that we have set up with a JDBC connection. So we have our Tomcat database here. We'll be able to kick this off, creating the data model and defining those fields that we want included in the employee. So initially, Appian's going to suggest some fields that it expects that we might want to use. We've got a created by, created on, modified by, modified on. Those are fields that are going to be useful for our audit trail. It's also going to suggest some other commonly used fields. Some, we might want an employee name, an employee description, a start date, an end date. We might want to know if they're active. We might have a user assigned to that employee. However, note that none of these fields, we're not tied to any of them. So if I did want to remove some of these fields that have been automatically added, I could do that. Let's say I really only want the created by field. And I can also start to add choice lists. So if I need a field that's more complex than just name being a text, number, date and time, Boolean, I can start to add more complex fields. So I could even tell Appian that one of these fields is a user field or a group field, and that's going to help Appian automatically generate user pickers to populate that field, group pickers to populate that field. Similarly, over here, I could generate a choice list. So let's say that I wanted to have multiple different statuses for my employee. Appian can go ahead behind the scenes and create this reference table for us and all the different relationships that I'll need to allow Appian to include this choice list in my application. So let's do the choice list field. Let's capture a few different employee statuses. So let's say we're going to have one status that's called not yet onboarded, another that says onboarding in progress, and one says like onboarding complete, for example. Of course, these are highly configurable, and we could preview the database script that Appian's going to run for us. So Appian's going to go and run some SQL statement for us, but we don't actually have to know SQL. We don't have to interact with SQL at all to achieve this database change. So we'll create the choice list. Appian's going to execute those database changes, create that new data entity, which is going to be the employee status list. And when we move on to the next page, we can add additional relationships beyond just the status. So we also have a created by user relationship. With the user who creates this employee record, we'll be able to capture that relationship too. So finally, I can see that I now have some relationships captured. These are many-to-one relationships and a one-to-many relationship. And as we go building out the data entities in this application, that's going to form the data fabric underlying our application, or the connection of all the data underlying this application that's going to allow us to see all the information that we need in a single place to take action on it. So let's save the changes here. We've gone ahead, we've set up these employee data fields now, and let's move on to what else we're going to need around this employee in the application. So right away, we've got that relationship. We have tracking the, you know, database source that we're using for the table that's holding this employee data. Over here, we can see our data model or the different fields that we defined around this employee. And we can even preview the database. If we were linking up to an external reference table that already had data in it, we'd be able to preview it right here. But we just defined this data from scratch. We don't have a table yet. So let's get started making some workflows to actually add data into this table. So moving over into actions, this is where we can generate actions for our record. Appian makes it really easy, gets you off to a strong functional baseline of generating actions for CRUD processes. So create, update, and delete processes. We're going to be able to generate these actions with just a few clicks, selecting if we want all of these workflows created or only one or two of them, or perhaps just one of them. And Appian's automatically going to take care of generating the interfaces, the business rules, the workflows that we need to have all of these different actions as part of our application. So once these are all started, we'll of course be able to make changes to them later using drag and drop and low code tools of the Appian platform to add additional steps. Of course, adding a new employee, that's going to become a very complex workflow in this application. There's going to be reviews. There might even be an AI skill to classify documents that we upload. So we'll be able to build that out later on. But for now, just by generating these processes, we have a strong functional baseline. So let's change hats now into the end user view of this application. We're going to be able to pivot from where we are right now, which is as a developer, looking at this application as an end user. And we have this empty table. So we did create the structure for this employee. Of course, we've got the different fields we defined here, name, description, start date, end date, is active, created by user, and status, but we haven't added any data yet. But of course, we also generated that workflow to create a new employee or add a new employee to this table. And so we can kick that off here and we can see the interface that Appian generated for us. So I can add a name. I can add my start date using Appian's native date picker field. So I could say they're starting Monday. An end date, you know, we'll leave this blank for now. I can add my description. Of course, this is going to be active and we'll add the status. We're able to use that pick list that we defined. So Appian went and created that table, populated it with values, and now even created this drop-down field for us to then select that this employee is not yet onboarded. And this is a user picker. I can select myself that I created this employee. Hitting create, Appian's going to kick off that workflow. And now we see we've got really bare bones record list, really bare bones record list holding all the different employees for us right here. And we can see that workflow was successful. So moving back over into our employee record, this is where we'd start to rinse and repeat with these other activities. We could add some record level security rules. This is going to be business rules to configure who is allowed to see the employee. Let me add a new security rule right here. So I can define that anyone in a certain group could see a certain employee, or I can define it by the field level. So maybe I want to say only users who created an employee should be able to see it. I can add that rule without having to do any code, just with point and click. And then I could go in and test and make sure that, you know, that user who we had just add that latest employee, they should be able to see that record. They can see it. We could even preview to make sure that that security rule is working properly. We also can go into views. We can start to generate interfaces to view the employee. We can change how the users filter down through the employees. Appian automatically generated a user filter for the status because we created that relationship. So that's getting us off to a good start there too. But we can start to add other filters. And of course, we can change the list view, which is that default view of viewing a list of employees. As well as finally, we could be able to generate employee events. So this is going to be that audit trail for an employee in the application. Appian can capture when certain events happen automatically. It'll timestamp and grab the user who completed those events and create that audit trail for us. So a lot of features here in the Appian Record Designer that's going to help us build that foundation of data that's going to underlie the application and help our business users achieve their missions by being able to see all the data they need from a single place. Thanks so much for watching. If you like this, don't forget to like the video and subscribe for more content, and we'll see you next time.